When programming macros in Genius Lab, input and output patching are special operations that can only be captured rather than manually programmed. So let me show you how to make a macro to patch a mix bus output to a spare IEM transmitter in case the regular in-ear monitoring system requires urgent replacement during a show. If you're new to Genius Lab and RIVAGE PM version 6, don't miss my previous videos to get an introduction and some simpler examples. This one is going to have a few more steps to follow. So I have 6 stereo in-ear mixes using mix buses 1 to 12. The regular patch for these is via twin lane to an RPIO unit. Though it would be a similar method if using Dante with RIO units. I have a spare IEM transmitter patched to RPIO outputs 13 and 14. This should be used by any of the mixed buses when their system malfunctions or runs out of battery. But of course, it can only be used by one stereo mix at a time. Once set, it should not be changed by accident. With RIVAGE PM10 and PM7 consoles, we have the option of using the function keys as triggers for this. But let's use a bank of user-defined keys instead, so it's applicable to all sizes of RIVAGE PM console. Let's set up a macro for changing the output patch of mix buses 1 and 2 first. Create a new macro and name it something like IEM1 to spare. Then open capture, clear all, press and hold down the required user-defined key, such as bank D number 1. Import this as a trigger and then release the key. Open the output patch on another screen, set the new patch, and if you wish, clear the previous patch, though you might want to leave that active. Import those patch changes as actions. Then, when this action gets activated, let's light up the LED and show some text. So, add some actions. We want the user-defined category, and then the function is keys, LED, and state. Set it for user-defined bank D, key 1, and then, of course, the value should be on. Add another user-defined action. This time, the function will be keys, label, and color. Again, bank D, key 1, and the value is going to be the color, red. One more action with user define and keys, label, name, and line. Bank D, key 1, line 1, and in the value field we are going to type some text like 1 on. Let's enable a macro and see how it looks when pressing the UDK. Of course, we have no way of disabling it yet. We'll get to that. But practically, if we need this function during a show, we may need to protect the patch change by making it recall safe. So let's add that into the list of actions. Look at Recall Safe on another screen and capture switching Recall Safe on and setting patch on for mix buses 1 and 2. Then import them into the list of actions. Also, we want to stop this mix bus from using the spare output if another mix bus is already using it. If we're planning to use user defined keys 1 to 6 to set each of the stereo mixes to the spare output, we should add a condition that this only works when all 6 are inactive. So once the first mix bus is sent to the spare output, no others can be patched there. The conditions category needs to be user define. And again, the function is going to be keys LED state. Set the parameters to UDK bank D and the numbers in advanced mode 1, 2, 6. Then the value must be off. Also, set the condition logic to AND. So it requires all 6 LEDs to be off for the trigger to work. We can't test this quite yet, as we don't have a way to switch the user-defined keys LED off. So let's use a combination of user-defined key numbers 7 and 8 for that. They can be pressed together to reset the patches back to normal, disable the recall safe. Using 2 keys for this is safer than 1 to avoid accidents. Create a new macro and label it IEM reset. Then capture user defined keys bank D numbers 7 and 8. Import both as a trigger while keeping the keys pressed. Then change the trigger logic to AND. That means both must be pressed at the same time to trigger the actions. Now we need to capture the required actions. Clear all, then disable the patch recall safe for mixes 1 to 12. And reset the output patch. Now we can import all these as actions. Next, set new actions to extinguish the other user-defined keys LEDs. So, a new action, user define, and the function is keys LED state for bank D keys in advanced mode 1, 2, 6, and the value should be off. Duplicate this action and then change the function to label color and then set the value to green. Duplicate once more, and this time we're going to have label, name and line, and we shall set the text to say normal. Now we can enable the macro and test. Switch 7 doesn't work by itself, switch 8 doesn't work by itself, but together they activate the macro. Of course, you could spend more time customizing the labels and colors as you wish. But for now, let's finish by copying the behavior of user-defined key 1 to the other 5 keys. In the macro list, highlight the macro and duplicate it. Rename it as IEM2 to spare. Then edit the trigger to use user-defined key number 2 instead of number 1, and edit the actions to target the correct mix buses and user-defined key. Now, the patch settings, however, cannot be edited. They need to be deleted and then recaptured with the correct patch for each key. Duplicate again for the remaining 4 keys. Obviously, this will take some time with so many actions in each macro. When you're done, test and verify the behavior. We have a working system using quite a lot of macro features. If you could follow each step, you must be feeling empowered to create more useful shortcuts of your own within Genius Lab. Though there are still many more features to explore. Find my other videos about them. Keep on learning and finding creative solutions to keep your mixing workflow efficient. Bye for now. Thank you.